Hello students, welcome to you in my channel.
Hello everyone, I'm Varna Vikas of class 5th in KV number 3, Delhi Cant. In this video, I'm going to present a story of my English book chapter 2, Flying Together through Shadow Puppet Show.
Deep in a forest stood a very tall tree. Its leafy branches spread out like strong arms. This tree was the home of a flock of wild geese. They felt safe there. One of the geese was a wise old bird. He noticed a small creeper at the foot of the tree. He spoke to the other birds about it. Wise old bird said,
"Do you see that creeper? Let us destroy it."
"Why must we destroy it?" asked the geese in surprise. "It is so small. What harm can it do?"
"My friends, that little creeper will soon grow. As it creeps up this tree, it will become thick and strong."
"What of that? What harm can a creeper do us?"
"Don't you see? With the help of that creeper, it will be possible for someone to climb this tree. A hunter can come up and kill us all."
"Well, there is no hurry. The creeper is very small. It would be a pity to destroy it now."
"Destroy that creeper while it is still young. Now it is tender and you can cut it easily. Later, it will become hard and you will not be able to cut it."
"We will see." Young flock of geese answered the wise bird, but they did not destroy the creeper. They forgot the wise old bird's advice. As the creeper grew, it began winding its way up the tree. Stronger and stronger it became until it was as strong as a thick rope. One morning, when the geese had gone out in search of food, a hunter came to the forest.
So this is where the wild geese live. Oh wow, when they will come back in the evening, I shall catch them."
The hunter climbed up the tree with the help of the creeper. He got to the top and spread his net there. Then he climbed down and went away. In the evening, the geese returned home. They did not notice the net. As they flew into the tree, they were trapped. They struggled hard to get out, but could not. "Help! Help! Help! Help!" cried the geese. "We are caught in the hunter's net. Oh, what shall we do?"
"Oh, don't make a fuss now. Long ago, I told you to destroy the creeper, but you did not. Now see what has happened. Tomorrow morning, the hunter will come back and kill us all."
"We were foolish," wept the birds. "We are very sorry. We did not listen to you. Please tell us what to do."
"Then listen carefully. When the hunter comes, you must all pretend to be dead. Just lie still. The hunter will not want dead birds. He will throw us to the ground. It will then be easy for him to climb down. Collect the dead birds and take them home. When the last of us has been thrown down, we must quickly get up and fly away."
In the morning, the hunter came to the tree and climbed up. He looked at the geese in the net.
"Oh, they all are dead,"
he muttered to himself. He threw them out of the net one by one. The birds lay still until the last one had been thrown down. Then, all at once, they got up, flapped their wings and flew away. The hunter was taken by surprise. From the top of the tree, he watched all the geese fly away.
So, moral of the story is, what are some of the things your parents and teachers tell you to do on time? Get up in the morning, do the homework, pack your school bag. So, obey your parents and teachers' suggestions and do your work on time. Thank you.